Hello students, as we are seeing the lectures in the utilization of electrical energy subject in illuminations, various type of light sources we are seeing, incandescent lamps, after that gaseous discharge lamps, in the continuous of the lectures. In this video, we are going to see the CFL, LED and neon lamps. Okay, these three lamp, compact fluorescent lamp, light emitting diode and neon tubes are our content. Okay, day-to-day life we are using the CFL. Okay, this is also a kind of fluorescent lamp. It is having the energy efficiency of the fluorescent light. At the same time, it has the convenience and popularity of the incandescent fixtures. And then CFL is replace the incandescents 3 to 4 times of their wattage, which means it can save the 70% of the initial light energy. CFLs are most cost effective in areas where lights are on for long periods of time. Where we need the light should on for long time, there we can use the CFL. And then CFL radiates a light spectrum different from the incandescent lamps, and then improved fast formulation have improved the perceived color of the light emitted by CFLs, such that some sources rate the best soft white CFLs subjectively similar in the color to standard incandescent lamp. Actually here in fluorescent lamp we use the phosphors. Okay, it will give the color. Okay, the soft white it will give. It is standard, it is similar to the standard incandescent lamps color. Okay, here we are seeing the parts. Okay, the bulb, the there is a two kind of structure is there. One is a helical, another one is what we are seeing here like this. So here inside the phosphor coating is there, and then here this is the ballast circuit is there, and then base. In ballast you can see some electronics elements are there. Okay, in this inside mercury vapor and argon gas also there. Okay, we will see the operation of the CFL. CFL work much like standard fluorescent lamp. They consist two components, that is gas filled tube and a magnetic or electronic ballast. So two components, gas filled tube and then ballast. The gas in the tube glows with ultraviolet light when switched on. An electric current from the ballast flows through it. So when we switch on, the light will glow. Okay, through the ballast, the current will flow through that gas. This in turn excites a white phosphor coating on inside that tube, which emits visible light throughout the tube surface. So this phosphor coating will help the CFL to give the white the visible light throughout the tube surface. CFLs with magnetic ballast flicker slightly at start. They are also heavier than those electronic ballast. Actually here we are considering the magnetic ballast or electronic ballast. Magnetic ballast is when it is starting, it will flicker slightly. Okay, but in electronic ballast, it is more expensive and more efficient. Okay, in that the tube will be last 10,000 hours, and then ballast will be last 50,000 hours. So it is having more life. Electronic ballast contains small circuit board with rectifier, a filter capacitor, and a two switching transistor. Okay, this is connected as a high frequency resonance series DC-DC inverter. Okay, these are the few advantages and disadvantages of the CFL. The lifespan is 10 times more than the incandescent lamp. But if you on and off within 5 minutes, okay, it will reduce the cycle of the lifespan. Second thing, energy efficiency. This is 22-33% equivalent in the power equivalent in the given light output, which means the same output light output will be available, but we can give only 22-33% of the power. So that is the energy efficiency. Less power, the same light. Third thing, heating is less. In indoor, we can use so it is less heating. But in cooler climate, we need a heating system. That heating system need more electrical energy. In fourth point, the efficiency, the luminous efficiency of the CFL is 60-72 lumens per watt. And then starting time, it will start instant on. It will on instantly. For getting the full brightness, it will take 3 minutes. Some disadvantages there in CFL. One is health issues. Okay, if suppose we use less than 20 centimeter distance, it will expose the ultraviolet rays, so that will affect our health. And then environmental issues. Actually, in this CFL, in the tube, okay, there is a mercury is there. And then, so what will happen if the disposal is not happened properly? This mercury is very poison one, so it will pollute the land also, and then it will lead to air pollution and water pollution also. So the disposal of the CFL is very, very important. Now we will see the neon signs. Okay, in top left corner we are seeing the like light. That is a neon signs. The neon signs will be like that only. Okay, we will see now how the neon will work. Gold cathode discharge lamps are low current and high voltage type, which neither employ cathode heating nor special starting electrode. So gold cathode discharge lamps, it is high voltage type and low current type. The discharge between electrodes takes place through desired gas and a low pressure. So the discharge is happening between the two electrodes under the low pressure, and then the neon gas having the pink color. Neon gas discharge has the characteristics of pink color. If we mix the mercury vapor and argon gas, it will give the blue green color. If we mix the mercury and neon, it will give the blue color. So maximum for advertisement, and then in big malls and all, you can see this neon signs. Other colors also can be obtained by the fluorescent powders. For voltage, for glowing this neon signs, the voltage may vary from 300 volt to 1000 volts per meter of the tube length, and current will be 25, 30 or 60 milliampere for the 10, 15 and 20 mm diameter tubes respectively. Okay, cold cathode lamp requires starting voltage about 1.2 times its normal running voltage. So its starting voltage need is 1.5 to 2 times of the full load, the normal running voltage. The supply is therefore given to them through high leakage transformer. The transformer has got magnetic shunt by adjustment of which magnitude current through the tube is adjusted. So here the letters will be connected through the terminals. For example, one letter P is there. Two side it will be connected. Two terminal will be connected through the supply through the transformer. Okay. From the safety point of view, no part of installation is to be 5000 volts above the ground level. Therefore, transformers having the secondary level of 10,000 volt with center tapping connected to earth will be used. If the length of the sign tube requires voltage more than 10,000 volt, it is split up in parts. The reason is in above ground level we have to use only up to 5000 volt. So it can be splitted, then it can be used. The letters, if we use any letter, that will have a two end. So the two end will be connected to the electrodes. This means the electrodes will be two electrodes will be in the letters. Now we will see the LED. LED is the electronic device, light emitting diode. That is a diode. Okay, that LED lamp, it is having the LED light bulb. Okay, it produces the more lighting in less energy. It consumes very less energy, and then it gives the good lumens light. LED lamps have a lifespan many times longer than the equivalent incandescent lamps, and are significantly more efficient than the most fluorescent lamps. Actually, this as of 2016, many LEDs is only 10% of energy of the incandescent lamp. So for the same brightness, it is giving only 10% of the brightness. How it is working? The light emitting diode simply we know as diode. When the diode is forward bias, the electron and holes are moving fast across the junction, and they are combining constantly, removing one another out. Soon after, the electrons are moving from the n-type to the p-type silicon, it combines with the holes, then it disappears. Actually, here the recombination of the hole pairs, okay, the photons will be come out. That is the light. Hence, it makes the complete atom and more stable, and it gives the little burst of the energy in the form of tiny packet of photon of light. So this is the LED where we can use. Okay, nowadays we are using LED in a wide range. Okay, because that is the energy efficient lamp. Okay, we can use for the special purpose also. If you want to use the color light, we can get the color LEDs also. Okay, if you want to use AC, we can use by the LED driver. It will give the enough supply. Oh, what supply you need for the LED bulb, it will give. It can be replaced. LED lamps are used for both general and special purpose lighting. Where color lighting is needed, LEDs that inherently emit the light of single color require no energy absorbing filters. LED lamps are commonly available as drop-in replacement for either bulbs or fixtures, replacing either an entire fixture, LED and LED light panels replacing the fluorescent flow for and spotlight filters, everything. And fluorescence tube inside probes or LED replacement is replacing the HID bulbs inside the HID fixtures. So any bulb we can replace with the LED bulb. The difference between the replacing fixture and replacing a bulb, when a fixture is replaced with something like LED panel, the panel must be replaced in a entirely. If the LEDs are driver contains fail since it is impossible to replace. To replace in a individually. So we can use only the bulb is will be replaced with a LED replacement of LED replacement lamp. Okay, here we discuss about the replacement of LED lamp. We can replace the fixture also, and then we can replace the bulb also. And then many areas we know the application of the LED in electronics kit for indicator, for signals, many areas we are using the LED. Thank you.